Marcello Mastroianni rose to stardom in the 1950s and became Italy's most famous actor due to his incredible talent and continuous collaborations with esteemed Italian directors. Due to his incomparable fame, Marcello Mastroianni was collectively regarded as the quintessential Italian man, as the incarnation of the Mediterranean Latin lover, and as the epitome of the Italian masculinity. While Marcello does embody the Latin lover archetype in some of his films, despite public opinion, he does not adhere to the traditional divismo role. Divismo is a phenomenon where the actor interprets similar roles in which his or her personality shapes the role he or she plays. Although he garnered the reputation of the ultimate Italian machismo and was worshipped by Italian and international audiences, some of his greatest roles showcase an opposition to traditional ideal of Italian masculinity. Two of Marcello's most famous films, Divorce Italian Style and 8½, use irony and comedy to comment and critique Italian masculinity and its effect on society and the male psyche. The concept of bella figura, which is the manifestation of the private self in the public arena, is a crucial component of the formation of Italian masculinity. In contrast to the traditional norms of the Italian male, comes the idea of the Eneto. The Eneto began as a stock character in the Commedia dell'arte and is known as passive, cowardly, and physically or emotionally impotent. Although released in 1961, Pietro Germi's Divorce Italian Style engages the historical concepts of the Eneto and Bella Figura to ultimately critique and dissect the senseless, male-dominated, and insular culture. Using the Commedia alla Italiana style, Marcello portrays the over-cherished and exasperated Sicilian baron Fefe in a comedic yet overly ironic tone. The necessity for public approval is prominent in the film, with many scenes of the voyeuristic Sicilian male community. These sequences duly provide a universal application to the film's more and showcase the concept of the bella figura. The main critique of Italian masculinity lies within Fefe himself. Jeremy's cinematic devices of voiceover narration and fanciful dream sequences allow the audience to peer inside Fefe's mind to see his true motives and truly understand the absurdity of their cultural traditions. Although Fefe skillfully upholds his bella figura, the audience is also able to move beyond the public perception and see his Eneto qualities. The audience clearly witnesses Fefe's multiple ineptitudes as he fails to fully record Rosalia's adulterous confession, misses her departure on the train, and arrives second to the murder scene. Fefe is an expert at hiding his Eneto. Throughout the film, Fefe predicts his future lawyer's defense in court and changes his actions so that the defense paints Fefe in the most innocent light. Although Fefe has deliberately planned his wife's affair, he changes his public mannerisms after the affair has become public knowledge. Before the affair, he walks with poise and elegance. After, he sheepishly and sluggishly hides from his peers. In the end, we see that the traditional norms of Italian masculinity are an act and a facade. Although historical, traditional masculinity is not natural or authentic, but rather something that can be manipulated. While Divorce Italian Style reveals the absurdity and superficiality of the traditional notion of Italian masculinity, Fellini's 8½ takes the critique a step further by revealing the anxiety men feel in reaction to the cultural norm. In the film, Marcello plays Guido, a director with writer's block. Fellini uses stream-of-consciousness editing to blend Guido's exterior surroundings, inner thoughts, past memories, and dreams. Like in Divorce Italian Style, 8½ features fantasies. However, unlike Divorce Italian Style, the fantasies in 8½ are less deliberate and emerge as reflections of Guido's psyche. Guido's anxiety centers on his past relationships with women and his desire to typecast each woman into one of three categories, the virgin, the mother, or the whore. This can be seen when he tries to make his mistress Carla into his whore fantasy by drawing eyebrows on her that he deems slutty. Later we see that Serenginia, the racy dancer he encounters as a youth, and who also initiates his sexual desires and frustrations, has the same eyebrows. The scene with Carla is followed by a dream sequence with his mother, further showing Guido's masculine anxiety in relation to the women in his life. The famous dream of the harem of women additionally showcases Guido's inner anxiety. The scene features women in Guido's real and imagined present and past. After pampering Guido, the women form a type of mutiny and critique his sexual performance. During the revolt, the camera drops to the floor in between the women's legs at an upward angle. This makes Guido look bigger and more powerful, which reflects his desired inner bravado. Wagner's Ride of the Valkyries plays as Guido uses the phallus-like whip to put the women back in order. However, rather than rejoice over his masculine dominance, Guido's reaction is somber. In reality, he understands that his machismo and Latin lover masculinity is not achievable and only exists in his fantasy. Therefore, the unrealistic quality of the ideal Italian masculinity is emphasized by putting its characteristics literally into the fantasy. Although he was known as a Latin lover by audiences, during his career, Marcello Mastroianni's roles actually criticized and ridiculed traditional Italian masculinity.